last video, we have discussed theoretically what is collection and what is list, right? So just a quick recap, we would be using collection in our Apex code a lot. I'm telling you, without using a collection like list, set or map, these three are the collection in Salesforce. Without using this collection, it's very hard to write a correct code. So we're gonna go and write collection in our day-to-day Apex coding definitely. In this video, we are going to learn what is list, how a list can be used to hold multiple data. So we have learned something called variable. Variable can hold only data. Next to inside the another data, it will replace the old one. List, which is a collection, which is a kind of a data structure, can hold multiple data. Okay, and this is the syntax, this is the signature to define a list inside Salesforce Apex class. In order to declare a list variable, right, you cannot put list the variable name. It has to be declared in this way: list bracket string. Let's say the variable name is LST is equals to new list and string. See, previous videos we have already covered up what is called static, right? You remember this, the static method, right? If a method is static, then you can call the method by just the class name dot method name. That's what we have explored so far. If a method is not static, then you have to first instantiate the class and then you have to call it. So this is what happens in Salesforce. List is nothing but a class, predefined class in Salesforce. Salesforce has already defined the class for you. And when you this is a variable, LST is a variable. Okay. This LST variable can hold only string type of data. Why? You made the list generic with string variable, which means this particular variable can hold only string type of data. This is how you declare a string, a list variable. Okay, to declare a string variable, what we do? It's just string str, that's it. And you can insert the value with like str is equals to, let's say, quotation Rajesh. But the way you insert data inside the list variable is also different. Okay, first of all, this is clear that why do you use list and not variable? Because variable can hold only one data, list can hold multiple data. Okay, now this is how you declare the list variable. List is a standard Apex class. Definitely, if it is a class, there would be a lot of method inside the class, right? Let me show you this list class in Salesforce. We'll go here and search something called list class in Salesforce. I want to show you something. See, if you go to this first link, list class Apex reference guide, check this out. List is a class which contains method for the list collection type. The list methods are all instance methods. This is something that you have to understand. The list method are all instance method. What do you mean by this? This means instance methods are basically non-static. Whenever a method is defined as static, that is called static method. If there is no static, that is instance method. Get it? And we have already discussed this in the last video that in order to call an instance method, you have to first create a reference variable of the class. Now let's understand this instance and static. The difference between static and non-static or instance method is static method can just be called with class name dot method name. But if it is an instance method, if there is no static involved, then you have to create a reference variable. What is it? You have to create a reference variable of that class, and with the reference variable you have to call the method. See, list is a class in Salesforce, and this is nothing but a reference variable. Okay, so if it is an instance method, in order to call your instance method in Apex class, you first have to instantiate the class, or you first have to create a reference variable of the class. And with the reference variable, you can call any method that is there inside the list class. You get it? Now, if you want to call the method, see, list has many methods written inside it. List class has many methods, like clear. Let's say you have something in the list and you want to clear the list. You want to make the list empty. Then there is a method called dot, method name is clear. And how do you call this method? You have to call the method like lst.clear. You are the difference between static and instance. If you want to call clear method lst.clear, clear. But if you want to call any static, let's say I want to call this method, how to use list. How do we do it? I will go here and I will just call this method with class name dot method name. Correct. This is where static versus instance comes in the picture. List is a class where all the methods that we have inside the list class is all instance method. So that is the reason why I have created this variable, and with the help of this reference variable, I'm going to call all the method. See, these kind of classes that are very helpful for us to write an Apex code. List is a class given by Salesforce to make our life easy, right? Because in the list class, Salesforce have defined many methods, and those methods will do the magic for us, correct? Now let's say I want to insert some value inside this LST. First of all, let me make this list clear. Anyway, there is no value so far inserted, so the list is cleared only, but still I made the list clear. And now if I have to add value inside this LST, how can I do it? You cannot simply put LST is equal to something. Okay, check this out. List class has a method called add. Is this clear why I'm using LST.add? Why not list.add? Because these methods are what? Instance method. We have read this, right? This line. The list methods are all instance method. That is, they operate on a particular instance of a list. Right? What do you mean by instance of a list? Nothing but this LST. LST is nothing but an instance of a list. You know what happened when you use this new operator to create this instance variable? In the database somewhere, a reference variable got created with LST. And whatever you want to do with this particular list class, you have to use this reference variable. Okay? So list has a method called add, which will help you to add something inside the list. Because this list is a string type of list, I can add only string. And how to add string? Quotation, let's say Java. List can hold multiple data, but variable cannot, correct? So I can copy the same line and I can add Java, Salesforce.net, let's say .net, and Apex. Now if you see this particular variable called LST hold Java and .NET and Apex. How do you know that? You have to go and print it, right? And we know how to print it, right? So I'll just go here, system.debug. By the way, what is system? System is also a predefined class in Salesforce. Now you can ask me why I'm using this debug, because this debug is what? Static method, right? It is not an instance method. That's why I am calling the debug method with system.debug. I hope you remember the system class. Let me just quickly show you again. System class in Salesforce. Whatever class you use, make sure you go and study about the class, right? Salesforce is a cloud product. Most of it is already been done for you. You just have to use those existing predefined classes that Salesforce has given to you. Okay, see, system class, the followings are method of system. All methods are static. You get it? All these methods that we have in the system class are static, and that's the reason why whenever I call system debug method, it is this class name, not method name. But for the case of list, you cannot call list.clear, list.add. You have to use the instance variable, because this is not a static method, this is an instance method. Alright, now how can I print this LST? I will just put LST is equals to LST. Okay, save. Pretty good. I will put control E, class name will be dot method name. What do you think? What would be the output if I call this method? See, I have highlighted this method and I'm just gonna click on this execute highlighted. I got an error, by the way. Method does not exist, incorrect signature, void, this. Let me check what is the problem here. So the class name is collection apex class. Sorry, see, the method name I have given wrong. So I'm gonna copy this, control V, and execute highlighted, and here we go. This is the log that has been opened, and if I click on the debug only, see, LST is equals to java.net and apex. What does it mean? It means this LST variable can hold Java and .net and apex, right? So this is how list can be used to replace variable to hold multiple data inside it. See, there is a use, okay, when you do the real apex coding. This is just the basics we are learning, correct? When I connect the dots, when I go and implement this list inside Salesforce, you will find there is a use of variable also in your real-time apex code, and there is a use of list inside your apex code. Cool. So again, don't get confused thinking that what is the real-time use of this. We are just learning the ABCD now. Okay, let's concentrate here, and once we learn pretty much how to deal with list, set and map as well, I'm gonna go and write a real program and show you how you can use this list, setup, map in your real apex coding program. Okay, so this list and how to add data inside the list is clear. I'm gonna use some other methods just to show you how other method inside this list class works. Okay, so next video we will continue the same list example only.